It's awful. My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Franklin, you've already been elected. Every cloud has a silver lining. You're never fully dressed without a smile. Oliver, where have you gone?
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning.
Who's this man here?
Mr. President, this is my good friend Annie. She so wanted to meet you that I couldn't resist bringing her along. Just to say hello.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Yes, Mr. President. Annie, if you could step outside.
No, no. Oh, let Annie stay. He'll keep us all on a pleasant meeting.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, that one is gosh. Franklin, good child. So, Oliver, as one of the happy few Americans who has any money left, I'd like to start with your views on the matter.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. Yes, and for the good of you, the country, Wall Street, and me, I need to get my factories open and the workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 15 million Americans out of work and now 15 million with no visible means of support.
And Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem. We have these pressures that are getting worse and worse. By then, it could be worse.
Jeremy, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run, we're
not. Cordell, for the people who are starving, there is no long run. The trouble is, it's all happening at once. The stock market has just taken another nosedive, and there's the sit-down strikes and the riots.
That's desperate.
And the FBI still hasn't got off the phone. Well, at least we all agree on one thing. The situation is hopelessly getting worse.
Henry, I'd like to see those figures.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Mr. Bottom Shh! Water.
Quiet, little girl. Harold. What was that, Annie? No, that's all right. Go ahead, my dear. It's still free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow. Clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none.
I've just decided that if my administration is going to any